Tony, have you even started getting dressed yet?
I've got my underwear picked out.
Well, don't bother looking nice. I look like a dump truck. Look, I don't mean to rush you or anything, but, you know, this is a justice of the peace. He's probably got another couple waiting in line right behind us. You don't want us to miss our own wedding, do you?
What the hell? Everyone else is. Are you sure we don't want to bring at least one witness of our own?
Don't think for a moment that you're free and clear because I didn't tell Tony the truth tonight.
I don't. But I think I know why you didn't.
You do?
Yeah. Because you saw for yourself how much he loves and wants this baby, AJ. If he thought for even a second that it wasn't his child, it would break his heart. That's why I asked you to wait until we both know for sure who the father is. And you know I'm right.
What about my feelings? But doesn't that figure into your equation? What if I am the father? I'm not even going to be there when my son or daughter is born.
You're not the father.
Says you. Excuse me if I don't take your word for it. But my silence has conditions.
What conditions?
No stunts. None. If you try to trick Tony into leaving town before this baby is born, or if you try to leave poor Charles on your own, all bets are off.
I promise you I won't.
It's not negotiable. Nothing. No wedding until after the baby is born.
Yeah, but...
No I do's, no rice, no cake until after the paternity test, or I'll tell Tony the truth.
Are you gonna get that?
We don't have time for anyone right now.
It could be your bouquet.
Right.
Don't say a word until I say jump, and then you may say how high, Uncle Luke.
Luke, we can't do
this. Sure we can, Caroline.
He's just in the bedroom.
Well, that's all the more reason for you to shut up and listen, so he'll still be there when I'm through.
Carly, who is it?
Honey, just get dressed before you come out, and could you get that? What do you think? You think you could stop this wedding now?
You know I can. In a heartbeat. But if that was my intention, I would have done it before Tony got his shoe shined. No, little lady. You got another runaway train headed your way by the name of Virginia Benson.
Oh, God. She didn't have another stroke, did she?
No. Are you kidding? That woman is the stroke recovery poster girl. She got her speech back. And now she won't shut up. She's talking about you, baby. Just you. Now, if you don't do something to shut her up, everything's going to unravel.
What do you want me to do? Look, I can't deal with this right now.
When are you going to deal with it? When? How long do you think you're going to be? Mrs. Jones, when Tony finds out that his wife should have been his stepdaughter...
He won't. Bobbie is not going to listen to anything my mom says. You told Bobbie my mother was a few marbles lost,
yeah, well,
right?
Your marbleless mother is now sending photos, baby, and good ones.
Well, I told her not to.
Well,
you
I don't care
hear.
What you told her. She's doing it. She didn't hear you. I intercepted this package, but I'm not spending my life sitting on Bobbie's doorstep waiting for the mail.
Okay, well, what do you want me to do, Luke? Huh? You want me to go over there and call her up and say, gee, Mom, I hear you're in touch with the prostitute who gave birth to me.
Just a minute, baby. You using the word prostitute as an insult really rubs me the wrong way.
I'm just saying. I'm not supposed to know who Bobbie is or where she is. If I call my mom... You know, she'll call Bobbie up, and she'll say, well, gee, I thought you didn't know who Caroline was. She sure as hell knows you.
All right. You call Cuckoo, and you tell her you don't want to know anything about your birth mother.
Okay, but they're all best friends now, thanks to you. I cannot help you, Luke.
Help me?
Yeah, that's right. Okay, you may be my nightmare in life to live with, but dear, sweet, well-meaning Virginia is yours. Unless you threaten to kill her. I mean, that's how you solve all your problems, right?
Are you nuts? My problems? Whose life is going to fall apart here? Not mine, wayward niece.
Okay, look, I am carrying Tony's baby. You can't erase that. Nobody can erase that. And let's get real here. You don't give a damn about me. You're here because you told Bobbie more lies than I have. And you know, when it all comes out, she's going to think of you as my accomplice, which is true. I wouldn't be getting married today if it weren't for you. So, thank you for being such a great uncle. Now, will you please go to hell?
Is that this way? Let me tell you one thing. Let me let you in on one little piece of Spencer family history. Everybody who ever thought they got the best of me turned out to be wrong and dead.
That was Lucas. He wants us to stop by the Spencer house on the way so he can throw some rice at me.
Yeah, I don't see why not.
We'll talk about what you're going to name that kid later.
You've reached the home of Virginia Benson, and I'm so sorry I missed your call. Please leave a message when you hear the beep. Thank you.
Virginia? Hi, it's Luke Spencer. Remember me? Listen, I have something I need to talk to you about. Could you give me a ring?